Hello everyone and welcome back to another tutorial in Revit group 1 online. In the tutorial I will show you how to create another option for floating stair in Revit. You can check back link in description for our previous floating stair that I have created one. Anyway, we going to walk through to the stair for floating stair for this one. As you can see, here is our slab, here is our hanging stair that we support from our slab to our hanging stair, this one. Anyway, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, I invite you to subscribe my channel because I make video like this 4 or 5 a week, depend on I got more time to do recording. Anyway, of course I will bring more content about Revit. Okay, so let's follow along together for this tutorial. So I'm going to close all my window first before I am starting to create another stair that we walk through together. Okay, so let's close all first. I just press Ctrl N on my keyboard for a new project, and this one change to I prefer to metric architecture template, just hit okay. And my previous one, I just want to close and I don't want to save. Okay, here is my architecture template in Revit 2021 student version. By create our stair, I need to create floor first. After that, only I create our reference plane and copy that to use our roofs by extrusion. As I told you before, roofs by extrusion is we can work and use it to create many shapes that we want. Either ceiling, complete ceiling, we also can use for our roofs by extrusion for this one. Okay, let me try and talk with we continue to our tutorial. I'm going to architecture here, then finding for floor here. Just go to rectangle, then draw any floor, just any shape, just leave it like this. Hit escape a couple of times, just hit finish. Then I'm going to copy to clipboard and pass it to align to level 2, and go to my nose elevation because I don't want my elevation from level 1 to level 2 is too high. I want to edit first, select my level 2, and here in our property panel I can edit my elevation high and rename, and here you can double click here, you can edit as well. This one I want to 3 meter. Okay, let me cap all, then 3 meter, 3 millimeter, just it apply 3000 millimeter. Just go first, go back to my 3D here. Okay, here is our level 1 and here is our level 2. Again, go to level 1, go to stair here in architecture tab here, stair. Then just start something like, okay, let me go back first. Let me go back first, go to stair again here. Then for extra run width, I want to change it to 1.8 millimeter. And then they start from here, something like this. Then just hit OK. Go back to our 3D. Here is our stair here. So in this case, we do not need our railing and also our support. And I will turn off my riser here. Just show my trick only easier when I start copy. Just like on my stair here like this one, go to edit type here. Of course I don't want to affect my stair here, so I need to duplicate, then rename for, just say for, okay, just leave it like this, then press OK. And this one I'm going to here run tie here. I need to turn off my riser here, it's okay. And then for support here, right support and left support, I also close. Okay, here is a normal floating, but we want to create another stair just like this one. Then we need to open our slab first. Go to wireframe, then go to edit boundary, start rectangle, select rectangle like this one, start from here until here. Hit escape, then hit finish. So now my slab got opening. Here is our actual stair. 4 step from our previous one. Go to level 1 again. The trick to create our roofs by extrusion, we need to create a reference plan first. RP on my keyboard to create a reference plan. You can press anywhere that you want. I just press here. Then of course you need to rename. I rename it in on my property panel again. Just type for A for quick example. Go to my 3D again. Turn my 3D to front like this one. Go to roof here. Roofs by extrusion here, use this one. Name, then go to reference plan A that we reset name one, just hit OK. Then this one, just hit OK. You can check your working plan is running correctly or not, just hit this one and show. Okay, so now my working plan is correctly. So I turn off bed, then I can start draw already. Then it's time to start draw. Before we start draw, we need to duplicate our stair first and assign for material as well, and duplicate and change for floating stair. Just make it floating stair. Then for structure, we need to edit material. For thickness, I change it for 150, and for material type, I want assign to a new material type. Create new material here. Then we need to rename. Just rename it for stair. Floating stair. I think floating stair is better. Appearance library here, then finding for wood. For me in library from Autodesk, I really interested on bird color is quite nice for me. So just this one. Hit apply, then hit okay, then hit okay again, then okay again. Okay, it's time to draw our stair here. So I just start pop up from here like. Like this one until here, and for the top one I want to delete and filter as well. Radium, change it to 180. I think 180 is enough. Let's see together. Okay, just leave it 180. Hit escape a couple times, then I just hit finish. Okay, so now I am done my roofs by extrusion here, but I change option to stair. This one I need to drain like this until my stair here, and this one I need to adjust as well. Okay, it's closing. Go to front again. Then I need to move my bottom one until here. Just go to move command. Up something like this. Use align tool to align is better. Hit escape. Okay, so now we got our stair here as you can see, and profile here you can change also. Let's ask adjustment for profile this one first. You can select your stair here, roofs by extrusion here. Go to edit profile here, or you can double click on your stair. It also can edit profile. AL for align, I need to align for one by one. Let's get a couple times, then hit finish. As you can see now, my stair is running properly. Here is my slab, the connection from my stair to hanging of my stair. Then I turn on to perspective view for right view. Then we need to copy one by one. Select my stair here, then go to CO on my keyboard for copy. And this one, or you can select here. And here you need to take for multiple, because we want to copy to multiple. Sorry. So we start copy like this for every floor. Okay, so now we is almost there. Hit escape a couple times. Okay, here is our stair, but as you can see our hanging stair is coming up. So anyway, we need to edit profile. I'm going to front here like this one. Then I need to edit profile one by one. I just select my stair here like this, double click on my mouse, then AL for align from here to here to here. You need to select multiple alignment here. Then it's finished. And other is use the same process. Okay, let's practice together, just a few stairs only. For complex ceiling, you can use roofs by extrusion also can use. I need to align one by one. Finish. Let's do edit AL for line. Finish. Okay, five more. Okay, as you can see, this tool you cannot use our align tool. You need to arrange first, hit escape first, then I'm going to control Z, bad for my perspective line. This one I need to delete first. TR for align, align from here to here, then AL for align again, start align from bottom of floor here until here. And here and here I need to change go to my filter here, then radium here, just leave it for, let's try for 50. Okay, it's work. It's finished. And the last one we need to adjustment also. Just delete these two guys and this one. I'm going to drag down like this, connect from floor here like this one, and here drag down like this one. Then it's finished. Okay, and here there we go. So now we finish our stair here, as you can see, and here you can extrusion also for this one. You can adjustment. Okay, so let's adjustment together for this one. Again, I'm going to select this one again, go to front again, go to edit again, and then this one okay. This one need to delete first, then go to this one. So this one need to copy back. Go to right again, CO on my keyboard for copy from here until here. Escape couple time. This one, like this one. Select my stair here, find edit profile here. And this one I need to this one I need to lower down a bit, I think. Make this one align. Just hit finish, and there we go. So now we got our stair here for the last one, the top one. It's connection properly. And for my existing stair, I want to delete. Let's go to our level 1 here. Turn on our camera here. Start from here, like this one. And turn on for shadow. Let's change this one to realistic. Let's make adjustment for now. We finish our stair here. As you can see, our material is quite nice. And here I need to adjustment. Okay, let's adjustment our floor material first for. Okay guys, so here is our final result. We got two perspective here, and here is a hidden line for perspective with shadow, and this one is with a realistic for our stair here and realistic for our floor here. And of course I also turn on for shadow. I know we got some problem about our stair for the final extrusion, but I think you can adjustment by yourself because you get that point already for adjustment and for create stair. Anyway guys, thank you for watching and I see you for the next episode. Okay, hey, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, I invite you to subscribe my channel because I make a lot of content about Revit and you will get a lot of benefit from my channel. Okay guys, thank you for watching. I see you for the next episode for another tutorial in Revit. Thank you guys.